Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Plays and Fades, Week 5 edition. Week 5 is when things are going to start getting interesting. Everyone's played 4 games. That's enough of a sample size to understand who's good against the tight end, who's good against the running back. Let's get right into it with the plays this week, starting with the quarterback position. Phillip Rivers. The Chargers are playing the Giants, and the Giants defense isn't as good as last year. Trust me, I know I'm a Giants fan. In a game that should be close, I'm expecting both teams to throw a lot. The Chargers are the third most pass-dependent team in the NFL, and I think Rivers, with all his weapons, are in play this week. Next up, I'm gonna give you a running back that I think a lot of people are not gonna be playing this week, but I love him in his matchup. LeSean McCoy. The Bills are going on the road to Cincinnati. According to DVOA, the Cincinnati Bengals are the third worst team at defending running backs out the backfield. LeSean McCoy, going back to last year, 7 of his last 8 games has seen 5 or more targets. No Jordan Matthews, Zay Jones still coming into his own, and Charles Clay being the only option, Tyrod Taylor is going to look for McCoy out the backfield against a team that's not good at defending the pass. I like me McCoy, especially where he's priced. Might get him at a low percentage. Next up, a shitload of wide receivers I like this week. 2 are going to be featured in the same game. Randall Cobb, and once again, Dez Bryant. We'll start off with Randall Cobb. If you've watched the Cowboys this year, and if you picked on the Cowboys this year, targeting the slot wide receiver is the way to go. Cooper Kupp last week, touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald on Monday Night Football, touchdown. Even going back to week 1, Sterling Shepard even had a pretty decent game if you're playing on DraftKings full PPR. The way to beat the Cowboys, even going back to last year, is targeting that slot receiver. Ranking 30th at defending the slot wide receiver, but ranking 5th at defending wide receivers on the outside. Play Cobb. If you watched the video last week, you saw me talk up Dez Bryant, and he was in a good matchup. But this week, this is going to be the best matchup Dez is going to have the entire season. If the quarterback is half decent, take any wide receiver that's playing the Packers defense. Chances are that team is going to be in a shootout anyway, so they're going to have to throw because Rodgers is that good. I'm waiting for Dez to put an 8-150 and 3 touchdown game. Now I'm going to give you 2 more wide receivers that you could pair up with the quarterback I like this week. Keenan Allen and OBJ. In every game this year, Keenan Allen has seen double-digit targets. Nobody else in the NFL could say that. Big Giant fan over here, Giants are a one-trick pony. If it's not Odell, it's quiet. Casey Hayward on the other side might scare people off Odell Beckham, and also that Q that you're going to see by his picture. I think all these wide receivers right here are in play, especially these two if you're planning on starting Phillip Rivers. That's called an unconventional stack. We have the quarterback with his pass catcher, and then you throw a wide receiver coming back the other way. The reason why you do that, if your stack is killing, it means that the team is winning. Somebody got to catch the ball from the other side. Might as well have exposure in that game as well. Next up, the tight end position. Also featured in that game, Hunter Henry. Look at you, Hunter, making the list. The Giants cannot guard a tight end for the life of them. I think Hunter Henry is going to go underlooked this week. Because if you're a game log guy, he hasn't really broke out this year. This is a week that he's going to find the end zone. Play Hunter Henry at tight end. Last but not least, the defenses. I'm going to give you 2 to play this week, simply because I don't know who's playing quarterback in Tennessee. So we'll start off with the Miami Dolphins and the Philadelphia Eagles. If Matt Castle's playing quarterback for the Titans, the Dolphins are the cheapest defense on FanDuel. Play them. If Mariota ends up playing, you can go with the Eagles. The Eagles are at home as a favorite playing the Arizona Cardinals. No offense in the NFL asks their quarterback to take more 7-step drops than the Arizona Cardinals. What does that mean? The more of a drop back, the more of a pass rush. Carson Palmer got sacked 6 times last week, and this defensive line in Philly is way better than the one that he saw in San Francisco. Let's move on over to the fade section, and let's remember, you're going to see some names on here that you're going to call me crazy. It might not always mean that they're going to have a bad game if they're in the fades. Sometimes a guy is just priced way too high. So let's get right into the quarterback position this week. Russell Wilson. Historically, a quarterback that when he plays on the road isn't that great. Last time he was on the road, though, threw for 4 touchdowns against the Tennessee Titans. But a lot of people in LA are optimistic with the Rams defense this year, and the Rams in general. Even when the Seahawks were going to all these Super Bowls, the Rams always played them tough, and Russell Wilson always struggles against the Rams. I'm staying away from Russell Wilson this week. Next up, also featured in that game, is a running back that I'm staying away from simply because of his price. Todd Gurley, that's better. I think a lot of people are going to be on Gurley this week just because of his usage, and he's starting to become matchup proof, so it's something to monitor going forward. But I just love McCoy this week. Both are featured around the same price range. I think Seattle's really going to try to stop Todd Gurley and make Jared Goff beat him. Next up, a running back I'm fading simply because of price, Le'Veon Bell, $9,500. On FanDuel. If you're playing in cash, I think Bell is a great play, but if you're playing in GPPs, which are the big tournaments, you're going to need him to score 25 points for you. I think that's asking a lot against a team that's pretty good against the run. Next up, the wide receiver that you're going to see, should have just left him on there from last week. Amari Cooper. I'm starting to sell my stock on Amari Cooper across the board. This guy's just not fast. He can't get any separation from the defensive backs. Cooper's been struggling with Derek Carr. Now you want me to believe in EJ Manuel getting him the ball? No thanks. Staying away from Cooper. Last but not least, the defense that I'm going to stay away from. And I kind of had a hard time picking one, so I'm going to just go with the defense that I think a lot of people are going to be looking at. Houston Texans. Houston last week crushed, and they're playing the Kansas City Chiefs on Sunday Night Football. A lot of people like to take the defense and the kickers featured in those Sunday Night Football games just to have something to bank on for that night game. I think there was a pricing error on the Texans this week. I think they should be a lot lower because Kansas City is one of the best offenses in football this week. Easy fade for me on the Houston Texans. So there you have it, the plays and fades that I got for week five. Before we go though, I want to give you guys a little bonus this week. Two games that I think you should definitely spotlight and get as much exposure to as you can. The Chargers-Giants game and the Packer-Cowboy game. Just pick and choose any wide receiver or running back and I think they'll have big games and it'll help you out. Also target those kickers in those games. If you guys like what you've seen or what you've heard, give a thumbs up on the video down below. Also down below in the bio is a link to my betting and DFS podcast titled Degeneration Bets. Every Fridays when this video comes out, a podcast comes out dedicated to DFS where I give you a more detailed explanation as to why I like players. If you want to contact me, @LamVM10 on all social media, and I'll see you guys next week.